Well, one, probably the first authority is to actually make this decision. There's a number of options that have been reviewed by other local authorities. As a metropolitan authority, we can take this decision to actually have a PCC as a full member of the authority with full voting rights. As Janet's rightly said, that she, the PCC will not be a member of any of the committee other than the police fire committee that we have at the moment, but that doesn't have any decision making rights at the moment. Anything that we get determined by that committee will be referred back to the full authority for approval. And that's where there might be issues there that might cause a conflict of interest, which you have to declare or not take part if that's the case. But I think that as we go forward in this new world of collaboration, I think that you know, we're sort of ticking the boxes of the government in a way closer with the emergency services. And this bill was only enacted early this year, and we've been very proactive in the way that we've responded to this. And it safeguards the authority in a sense that it restricts the PCC, this current PCC or any future PCC, from any ability for any hostile takeover. So hopefully we'll continue to operate as an authority in our own right. Until this time there's any change in legislation where we may then be the responsibility to take it on by the Metro Mayor, similar to what's happened in Greater Manchester. But that's probably one of the reasons that we've needed to explore, you know, all these options. And the report that went to the authority in June about the reform of our membership and the way the party has been established, and we're going to need to follow this meeting to see about what the next stages are and the time frame, and to consult with our partners to see what their views are before we come back with a recommendation to the authority in December. But also we've got to work closely with the Liverpool City Region Combined Authority to make sure that you know, we do all we can to protect the best interests of the service and obviously the what we do for our community. I think that's our primary aim, to make sure that the service can deliver an effective and efficient emergency first class service as we've come to expect and what we've come to expect. And I think for all of us, I'm sure, I think that's at the heart of all this, to make sure that we're the elected members to oversee the sort of responsibilities and strategies and policies of the authority. But it's the chief fire officer and the team to make sure that they deliver on that. And I think, you know, we're in a good place, right to where we're in the financial situation. We are in a good place with the work that we're doing and the work that we're doing with our best bodies. So I'm quite confident of the future, depending on any major sort of disasters. And if we can get any more money from the government, then that's all the better. But just to reassure members, I think that we are going in the right direction, and you know, we pick up lessons from what's happened in other parts of the country, where there's some areas that can't even decide on whether they want a combined authority, whether they want a metro mayor, whether they want to work together. So we're ahead of the game, and that's only a compliment to everybody who's been involved with all this work behind the scenes and for us ourselves as we go forward.
Councillor Sullivan, you're all right. As the bill was going through Parliament, there was some discussion that having another voting member might affect the balance of power of an authority. And I can't remember how that ended up in the Act, and it may not have done, but Merseyside's not so hung. I don't think it's particularly a problem for us. Sorry to say those things. In some places, you know, one extra vote might just change that balance of power. And I think there was some discussion about that in the Act, but where it ended up, we'd look at that.
There's naturally in the Act about that. It's simply subject to decision making, and I very much doubt that any authority that thought it would affect the balance of power would not have made an invitation like this in the first place. That doesn't mean to say that a PCC can't actually make that request themselves of their own motion. And ordinarily, that's what the legislation says should happen. It's been good, really, that it's been done this way here, because I think it shows an extension of the whole collaboration issue,
yeah,
really,
yeah.
And that people in two agencies actually want to work together. Mm.
And no matter what we do at member level, it's what the officers do at their level, which is probably the most practical. And there's very, very good working relations between police and fire officers. So we've had a good go at that. It agreed recommendations on what page 175 to that we amend the constitution to enable the PCC to become a member of the fire authority. So I agree, colleagues. Well, with that, thank you very much. End of the meeting. We'll close the filming now. Just to remind you, there's a...